Okay, for today's penmanship paper, we are going to be doing capital D, lowercase d. We're going to be doing 7 and 8. And you will be doing the word reading, and then there's some more things on the paper you need to do. Alright, so look up here. Do not be working on your paper. Jonathan, I said look up here. Do not be working on your paper. Well, I don't want you to write your name anymore. If you didn't have your name written already, it's time to stop and watch me demonstrate. You need to watch me demonstrate. Everybody's eyes up here, watching demonstration. Alright, you will do your warm-ups before you do this. So for D, are you watching? You're going to go down at a slant. You can make a little loop and touch the floor. And then come up and around and touch where you started it and then swoop out. Who can tell me something about capital D that we haven't had so far? Well, you wouldn't know because you don't know cursive, bud. What's something about capital D that capital A didn't do it, capital B didn't do it, capital C didn't do it, but capital D? Oh, that's not what I'm after. There's something special about
reverse?
It.
Reverse? It's kind of like O.
It's not what it's kind of like.
It only has its one step.
Okay, well, they all only have one step. Because you don't ever pick your pencil up. You do the whole thing without picking your pencil up. What I was getting at is it cannot connect. I was hoping somebody would remember that it cannot connect. Remember when we did capital A? Like when we did Adam, we could connect the capital A?
Yes.
And then when we did Bible, we could connect the B to the next letter like that.
Whoops. Yeah.
And let's say if we were going to do C, let's say we could do C and connect it. I'll be my cousin's name, Christine.
And can't lowercase B though?
Yeah, all the lowercase B's can connect. That's not a big loop, but my cat doesn't do it right. But capital D ends really high. It does not connect to the next letter. It cannot connect. You do not try to connect it. You just leave it standing alone. For lowercase d, what letter does it look like that we already learned? Zeke?
Me.
You might know the answer if you were actually listening to what I was saying, because it's not a hard one. Please listen, okay? Lowercase d, what letter does it look like that we've already learned? See? I knew you'd know. What does it look like that we already learned?
Okay.
Okay. Well, we've only learned A, B, or C. So out of A, B, or C, which one does lowercase D look like?
B.
Does it? Are you looking at the card? Look right here. Okay, does lowercase D look like B?
No.
No. Which one does it look like? Except it's not as tall. Okay, Leah.
Lowercase A.
It looks just like lowercase A, it just has a taller stick. So you start like you do lowercase A, just like you do lowercase A. You come up here, but instead of going back down, you keep going, and then you come back down. Now, look at capital D and lowercase D. Are they the same height?
No.
But is it as short as a normal lowercase letter?
No.
It's somewhere in between. Okay? It's not as tall as the tall letters, but it's not as short as the short letters. It's somewhere in between. All right, for 7, eyes up here. You're going to go across and then slant down. For 8, I like to say make an S and curve back up. That's how you do the 7 and the 8. All right, now I'll show you reading. For reading, you go up and down and then around, sort of like you do for a B, but then you give it a extra leg, like that. Then do the E, the A, up and around, back around, the D, up and around, back around, the I, up the driveway, down the driveway, one hop, two hops for N, up and around and back around for G, and then it has a tail. Then you go back and Dr. I. Okay, you may begin your papers.